Hello, everybody. This is Steve Munitonis from KAATSU Global. And I'm just going to briefly explain what your arm looks like when you're actually doing KAATSU. And if you look at this picture here, that shows a vein above and an artery below. The vein is what the blood comes out with, and the artery, the one below, is where the blood goes in. So if you look at the artery, actually, there's not much change to it. But if you look right above the vein, you can see where there's a slight indentation. And where that slight indentation is exactly where this band is. And so that's what KAATSU is. You put the band on, and this slight indentation in your vein occurs, and that makes your hand turn very, very pink. So with that, John, take it away.
Hey, happy Tuesday, everybody. Hope everybody's enjoying your COVID-19 lockdown, shelter in place, whatever you want to call it. This is just a little, I like to do this right before Laurel gets started every time, in case this is your first time joining us. We're going to start with the armband. So go ahead and preset your armband, slide it on your arm, go all the way up to your armpit, okay? Try not to let it slide down too low, all the way up there. And go ahead and make it snug, okay? And when I say snug, it's tough to get a finger under the band, but I can. I can get a finger under there, but it's not easy. Both bands should feel about the same. At base pressure like this, you still should have good capillary refill, okay? Now go ahead and take the Cycle 2.0 and push the power button. You'll hear a beep and you'll see the word cycle come up on the device. Go ahead and plug into the device, both sides, and they're just little friction plugs. And start your cycle. So you tap G, and I always start low and build. So now I'm doing my first cycle, and it says GL1. That's group, low, and it's the first of 8 cycles. The cycle lasts for 30 seconds of pressure, then 5 seconds off, then 30 seconds of a little more pressure, and 5 seconds off. The first thing you should do once you start with any pressure is look at your cap refill, safety first, and you should have that remain white no longer than 3 seconds. Okay, so that's a pretty low pressure. But throughout the workout, try to periodically check your cap refill time, your CRT, you'll hear us call it. A little pointer, when Laurel is in between sets, go ahead and end the cycle and start again either at the same, or if that was easy for you, go ahead and start at the next higher pressure. Anytime you start a cycle, it's going to last for between 4 or 5.5 minutes, depending on if you're doing arm bands or leg bands and what have you. Okay, Laurel, all you, awesome. Let's go.
Thanks, John. And Steve, so I've got Instagram on my right, I've got Zoom on my left, and we're all ready to dive in. We're going to start today by thinking about what it is you want to accomplish in your workout. So what is it that brought you here today to do this work? Is it to grow stronger, faster, leaner? Take a moment to just check in and think about whatever that why, that reason is for you. Take a moment to think about it. And there's really no wrong answer here. You made it here. We're going to do a really hard workout. We're just finding the purpose of that before we get going. And with that why in mind, as we go throughout our movements today, we're going to keep checking back in and coming back into that purpose at different points to kind of keep us motivated and keep us going, even when it gets hard. So with that being said, let's start with some shoulder work. We're doing mobility. So I want you to raise your arms up. Think like you're a cactus or a scarecrow, whatever analogy works best for you. And you're going to find your right hand, and you're going to start to rotate your right hand down towards the floor. Now find your left hand and start to press it back behind you. Now the elbows might start to sag. I want you to keep your elbows in line with your shoulders and squeeze those hands in opposite directions, wringing out as much movement in the shoulders as you can. Core and glutes are engaged. Squeeze it out. We have 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, right into the opposite direction. Make sure your elbows aren't sagging. Wring it out. Squeeze as much range as you can. This should be intense. Grow a little bit taller. We have 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Good, release it, shake it out. Maybe feeling a little bit of almost tingling in the fingers. We don't want numbness. That means your bands are on too tight. One more set for shoulder mobility. This time reaching your arms out towards side walls, fingertips in line with shoulders. Find your right palm, start to rotate it up. Left palm rotates back. So we're wringing the arms out in opposite directions. Squeeze out as much as you can. We have 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Opposite direction, wring it out. Pull the shoulders away from your ears. Keep reaching those fingers out. We have 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. One more time, opposite direction, last set. This time we're gonna go for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Last one, if your shoulders aren't burning a little bit, let me see a lot more, wring that out. We have 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and rest, roll it out, move it around. We're carving out space in our shoulder joint so we can more easily move our limbs in the joint. And it gets a little intense sometimes. So we've done shoulders. Let's move on to some spinal mobility, and then we're gonna jump into our work for the day. So for this one, I want you to take your hands across your chest to opposite shoulder. And I'm gonna turn to the side so you can see. Engaging your glutes, your core, I want you to start to lean forward. Now start to lean over to the right and make a big circle all the way around over to the left and back through center. So as you do this, your glutes, your core, nothing else moves, just your spine rotating around and coming back through center. So really keeping the core and the glutes engaged for stability so that we can isolate our spinal movement. We'll take one more. Over to the right, keep lengthening as you come up and back, around and center. Now let's go the other way. Over to the left, squeeze your glutes, lengthen up, bring it around, back and center. And we'll take three more here. Each time, see if you can squeeze out a little bit more range, maybe leaning back even farther. These are especially important if we've been sitting, we've been slouching a lot. We want to open everything up, moving that spine through a full range. Good. And last one. And come back through center. Shake the arms out. Give the spine a little twist. Move side to side. And then we're going to dive into our forearm exercises. Those of you who have been on the workouts know this very well. Those of you who are new, we always work out with our bands, starting arms, then legs, smaller muscles to bigger muscles. So we're gonna start with some forearm wrist circles. So starting with your left arm, pull the elbow in towards the midline of the body and actually grab your, I'd say, elbow crease to hold that body, that arm in place. Then make a fist with your left hand. And 30 seconds, we're gonna start to move the hand around in the wrist joint without letting the upper arm move. So time is rolling, keep moving through it. Circle that arm around. And halfway into it, we're gonna go the other way. So keep going, move that wrist one direction. Good, and now circle it the opposite direction. Again, this is a forearm exercise, but see how much range you can squeeze out with your wrist. Keep pulling the elbow in towards the body. We have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shake it out. And you should be starting to see veins, maybe a slightly darker color of the arms here. That's good. We want that. Let's do the other side. Glue the right arm into the body. Take your left hand. Pull that arm in. Keep it stable. 30 seconds. Make a fist. First rolling one direction. Good. Good. And the more of a fist, the more you squeeze, the more we'll do the work. So you can adjust accordingly. And then go ahead and roll the wrist around the other direction. Good. See if you can make it even slower, harder, more precise, working through the resistance of our own body. We have 5, 4, 3, 2, and shake it out. Roll the wrists around. Okay, let's move into some tricep bicep work. So we're going to come down onto our mat. It's called single arm push-up. So check your cycle. Come down onto one side, doesn't matter which one. I'm going to rest my bottom arm behind my head and root my top hand into the mat. And so we have 30 seconds per side. We press up and down, up and down, and we're moving. See how high off the floor you can get. Try and get that bottom arm pit off the floor. Better yet, see if you can get all the way off the side wrist, up and down. We can pick our pace, but see if you can fully extend your arm at the top. Lengthen out and down. Nice. Last 10. Okay. We're going to hold at the top in 5, 4, 3, 2. Press all the way up and hold it. Little pulses down and up. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. We're feeling it. 5, 4, 3, 2, press up and hold, lower down slowly, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Take that top arm, roll it out, and we'll make our way right onto the other side. Now you should feel that bottom arm starting to work. I know I certainly can. So roll onto your other side, take the bottom hand behind your head for support. Good. Root the top hand into the floor, 30 seconds. We are going. We press all the way up and down and up and down. I like it. Good. Woo, half done. We're going to work into it at the top as well. And down. In 10, we're going to press up and hold. We have 5, 4, 3, 2. Press up and hold it. Little pulses up and down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Press up, hold, lower down slowly, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good job. Come on up, shake it out. Okay. So starting to work into the shoulders, we're adding a core kick into the mix. It's called seated Arnold press. So I root my heels into the floor. My core has to do some work to keep me stable here. If you need a modification, you can just rest your feet on the floor. So once my heels are down, I press up, pull them in. I press up, pull them in. We're gonna do 2 30-second sets. The first one, we're going normal pace. The second one, we're gonna move fast. So everyone set yourself up, get those feet rooted in the floor. Now, how much you want to round out your spine is going to make the exercise more difficult on your core. So it's a choose your own adventure thing here. So let's set ourselves up, 30 seconds. We press out, up, bring them in. We go out, up, and bring them in. At no point do my elbows drop below my shoulders. Make those fists. Really extend your arms up on the reach. See if you can round out even more on the spine. Get low, in and up, in and up. Let me check in, last 10 seconds. All right, we have 5, 4, 3, 2, and rest. Roll out the shoulders. Second set, we're going fast. Not yet, take a moment. Let me see you go up, in, fast as you can, 30 seconds. Don't let those elbows drop and go up, in, really reaching up towards the ceiling. Every time you do it, up, in, yes. Checking in to see how everyone's doing. Keep going, Instagram. All right.
Yes. Last 10. Woo! We have 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Everybody rest. Can you guys hear me, Steve? Yes, no? You can hear me? You can. Okay, I'm getting thumbs up. I like it. Awesome. Yes, okay. Yes. Okay, got it. Couldn't check. Had to take my earpods out for a second. Good job. One more upper body exercise. Then we're going to go into our heart rate boost with the upper body, and we're going to move on to legs. So next up, we have military plank side tap. A lot of words for a simple move. So I'm in my plank. I go down, down, up, up, tap. Down, down, up, up, tap. Okay? Modification for this, you're on your knees. Down, down, up, up, tap your side. Okay? Again, 2 30-second sets. The first one, we're going moderate pace, so getting used to the movement, going slow, making sure that we can reach back on that tap without dropping our hips. And then the second set, we're gonna fly. First 30 seconds, come into your plank position. Time is going. We go down, down, up, up, tap. Down, down, up, up, tap. Keep going. Keep those hips stable. Don't let them wiggle. Remember, first 30 seconds is just a moderate pace to get used to it. We don't want to burn ourselves out. Keep that nice form. Hips are up. Last 10 seconds. Woo! In 5, we're going to drop the knees. Quick rest. And then we're going to go right into the second one. We have 4, 3, 2. Drop your knees. Take a quick breath. Then we're going to go right back into plank. Pop on up. Second set, go. 30 seconds, we're going fast. Make sure you get that arm straight back on the tap. No flopping. Totally fine to do this on our knees. As we go throughout our exercises, I'm always gonna offer modifications and alternatives. I need each one of you to listen to your bodies. Last 15 seconds, we are flying, keep going. Making sure you're breathing. Making sure your core, your glutes are supporting everything you do. You have 5, 4, 3, 2, rest. Come down on your knees. Grab a sip of water. And take a gander at the screen. I'm going to demonstrate our heart rate boost of the day. It's 3 moves, 30 seconds each. When I say heart rate boost, this is what we're doing. The first move, lateral floor taps. We go tap, tap, tap. Keeping your spine straight. None of this. We go tap. Bend to the front knee to get low. That's first move. Second move, crisscross jumps. Cross, 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 cross. And last one, we have what's called an X plank. So I'm in a plank position. I take right hand to left leg, shift forward. Switch and shift. Switch and shift. If a plank is not happening for you today, come onto your knees, alternate arm reaches, okay? So first 30 seconds, lateral floor taps. The faster you move, the higher your heart rate's gonna get, and that's what we're going for. Let's work through it. First 30 seconds, go. Tap, 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 and tap. Move fast on your feet, get low. Let me check in and see how everyone's doing. Awesome Instagram, keep going. Zoomers, I've got DS, Quentin, John, Steve. Yeah, Lucas, good. Sydney and Sophia, awesome, Justin. Last 5, 4, 3, 2. Hop up, crisscross jumps, 30 seconds, go. Getting those arms and those legs moving. See if you can move it really fast. Half done, keep going, get your heart rate up. Imagine you have neighbors underneath you, even if you don't, stay light on your toes. Criss cross, here we go. Last 10 seconds. In 5, we're gonna come down onto hands and knees for X planks. We have 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come down onto your hands and knees. Pop up into plank, last little bit of our heart rate boost. We tap hand opposite leg, shift. Tap, shift. Otherwise, on your knees, reach and reach. Final 30 seconds, go. And as you're doing this, do your best to keep your hamstrings, the backs of your legs, straight. So we're opening up our hamstrings as we do this multi-purpose move. Woo! Nice, keep pressing the floor away from you with your arms, last 10. Go, Chris. Go Ethan. Ladybug Lisa, I can't see you, but I'm rooting for you. Kayleen, awesome. 5, 4, 3, 2, and rest. Everyone come down. Shake it out. Grab your water. We're going to take a minute rest. I'm going to hand it over to Steve. If anyone has questions, give me a shout, and we're going to swap out to our leg bands.
I'm dying.
I know we had this trivia question last week, but I'm not convinced everyone remembers. What percentage of our muscle fibers do we use when we normally work out with no bands? Can anyone tell me? Steve, John, and Chris, you're not allowed to answer. Adam, you're not allowed to answer either. Any guesses?
65 to 75%.
65 to, close, close. Any other guesses?
68, I think.
68? You guys are pretty darn close. The number is, it's 60. Yeah. So we use about 60% of our muscle fibers. So 65, 68, you guys are getting there. Pretty really close. When we don't use our band, however, we do use our bands, KAATSU plug, we're at 90 to 98%. So maximum efficiency going on here. Once you get your bands on, pull them all the way up into your hip creases as high as you can. I have black pants, you can't exactly see. But once you get them all the way up, we want to angle the outer edges of our bands up towards our hips. So slight angle there, get them up as high as you can. Hook it up. Pop on that cycle. If no one has questions, we're going to keep going. Steve, any announcements? John, any announcements? No announcements? Okay. All right. We're rolling with it. Okay. If you've not already had a sip of water, please do that now. We need to stay hydrated while we do the work, especially with our bands. So, hip mobility work. Everyone come onto your hands and knees. Now, I want you to imagine that you have a brick, or if you have a water bottle, you can take it onto your back. That water bottle is going to roll off my back. If you have something handy, you can take it onto your back. I'm going to use this pillow. If you don't, it doesn't matter. You can imagine. So I'm going to start with my left leg, okay? So I'm pulling my left knee up and off the mat. And without letting the item fall off my back, I'm going to make as big a circle as I can. Move it all the way up, through, and back and around. I go all the way up, in, almost lost my pillow, and back and around. So we have 30 seconds moving that left leg through rotation. And just like with our arms, it should be intense. It should be active. Every time you make a circle, I want you to see it a little bit bigger each time, okay? So a common tendency we have here as we're doing this is to bend our right arm to compensate. I want both arms straight and strong. You're half done. Start moving your leg the opposite direction. So instead of going out and around, you go in and out. And if that doesn't make any sense, just move your leg around in the hip socket. We have 5 more seconds. See if you can take one more insanely slow rep. 4, 3, 2, rest. Fantastic. Right into the other side. So this time, making sure to keep our left arm straight. We pick our right knee off the mat. We open the hip out to the side, squeezing like heck, bring it up, around, and through. And if you have an item on your back, don't let it fall. 30 seconds. If you don't have an item on your back, think about there being 2 beams of light coming out of your hip creases, and I want your hip bones, and I want those beams of light facing down to the floor the whole time. Don't let them open up to the side. Awesome. Good. Move it around the other way. Nice, John. Hello, Chris. Good job. Good, Justin. iPhone Diana, I can't see you, but keep going. See if you can do one more. We have 5, 4, 3, 2, and rest. Now we did a similar move to this one with our X planks, but we're gonna keep working into our hamstring flexibility with an active move. So what it looks like is I come into a plank, I press my hips up and back. Now, trying to hear heels towards the floor, nice straight legs, and then shift forward into plank. We're not going for speed, we're going for pressing our hips back, working our heels closer to the floor each time we do this. So come on up into your plank, 30 seconds, the slower you can go, the better. So I wanna create a V shape with my body, we're moving. And after this, we'll get into some of our harder work. Good, and as you do this, actively pressing the floor away from you with your hands so that the arms are working as well. Cool. Awesome job, guys. Get those hips up and back. Last 10. Mm-hmm. We have 5, 4, 3, 2, press your hips up and back, pedal out the legs, bending alternate knees. And then walk your hands back to meet your feet, let yourself hang, shake your head, yes, And roll on up to stand. So just like arms with our leg bands, we work smaller muscles to bigger muscles. So we're gonna take a wide leg squat with alternate heel raise. So what that looks like is I come into squat, I go lift, lift, rise up. I go down, lift, lift, and rise. If that's not happening today, you can do alternate heel raises standing up, okay? So 2 30-second sets. First one, just normal, drop into it. Lift, lift, and rise. Drop into it, lift, lift, and we rise. If you wanna try the squat, but your balance is a bit challenging, you can take a hand to a wall, or you can just take a baby squat. The most thing we wanna focus on here is how high can you get the heel off the floor? Nice straight spine. Last 5, 4, 3, 2. Let's drop into our squat together. Lift your right heel off the mat, little pulses. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, you know what's coming, switch sides. 8, 7, getting even lower. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and rest. Take your hands to your hips, draw some circles, move the hips around. And move the hips around the other way. And start to come back through center. Second set, this time, see if you can do them. You squat, lift both, drop them, rise. Squat, both, drop, and rise. And if that's not working, you can just do it without the squat. Second 30 seconds, stay straight. Up, down, rise. Drop, lift, down, and rise. Awesome. Cool, half done. Feeling those calves, feeling those thighs as we open up our hips. And rise, last 10. And of course, we're gonna work into it. In 5, 4, 3, 2, lift those heels, whatever position you're in, whether it's squat or not, little lifts with the heels. Up, up, up. If your legs are not shaking, I don't know what to tell you. Drop your butt even lower. For 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, lift and hold, rise up, drop those heels, shake it out. Good job. All right, kick it out. Now let's get our heart rate back up. 3 moves, lateral floor taps, crisscross jacks, X planks. First 30 seconds, lateral floor taps, go. Side to side. Let me see you move fast. Reach, reach. Reach, checking in. Go Instagram, go. All right, chest up, keep your spine straight. Awesome, Lucas. Awesome, Camille. Go, Adam, go. In five, we're going to go into our crisscross jabs. We have four, three, two, crisscross jabs. Jab, and jab. And if jumping in the crisscross jab isn't working for you, you can step, step, step. Otherwise, cross, cross. 10 more seconds. Then we're going to come into plank position and either do the arm reaches or the X planks. We have five, four, three, two, one. Make your way down. Modification, arm reaches. Otherwise, X planks. Tap, shift, tap, shift. Pressing up and back even more each time. Feel those leg bands work. And up. Shift, up, and shift. Pick that pace up a little bit more. Get your body moving. Back. Back. Awesome. Last 10 seconds. Woo! Cool. We're gonna drop to hands and knees and take a sip of water in five, four, three, and two. Everyone, rest. Grab your water. Heart rate should be pumping. Let's rehydrate for a moment. Now, it's really hard to go too tight with the leg bands. So if you can fit more than one finger in your leg band, tighten those guys up. Also, remember, reset your cycle here so it doesn't stop when we're in the middle of our exercise. Grab your water. Questions, comments, shoot them my way. We'll get going in a second. All right, next up, we have multi-direction lateral lunge. So, starting with the right leg, it's a three-part lunge. You lunge forward, side, and back. We go forward, side, and back, okay? So, right side only. We're gonna get going. We're gonna go one side and then right into the other. So come on up to stand. First 30 seconds. We go forwards, side, and back. Bending into the moving knee the whole time. Forward, side, and back. So the left leg stays really straight, chest stays up. If you need a modification, just go out and in, out, and in. Last five, four, three, two. Switch sides, moving into the left leg. We go forward, up, side, up, and back. Whoop, gotta bend into my back. There we go. We go forward, up, side, get low, and back. 10 more seconds. Getting our body used to it before we do the second set. Nice. We have five, four, three, two. Come up to stand. Now, variation for the second set if you want more of a challenge. We go forward, hold, out, hold, back, hold, down, up, out, up, back, and up, okay? 30 seconds, back to the right leg. Either one is great, let's move. Ah. Up, bending lower each time. For some reason, my body just doesn't want to bend my leg when I go to the back. That is called proprioception. It's our brain knowing where any body part is at any given time. So exercises like these, where we move the legs in different planes of motion, we're not only increasing our strength, we're also increasing our proprioception. We have five, four, three, two. Switch sides into the left leg. See if we can get that little hover at the top. 30 seconds, go. Forward, up, side, up, back, and up. There we go. Cool, I see a lot of knee hovers. Good job guys with the balance. We've been working on that a lot last week and this week and I love it. We're getting stronger. Last 10. After this, we're going right to our heart rate boost. In 5, 4, 3, 2, come on up. Lateral floor taps, 30 seconds, let's go. Reach, reach, reach. We open up those hips with the lateral lunges. Now we should be able to step further and move faster. Go, and reach. See if you can get your fingertips down towards the floor, if not to the floor, and reach. Reach. In 10, we're gonna move on to cross jacks. We have 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hop up right into it, cross jack, go. Go Instagram, keep going. Team Zoom, cool. I'm seeing legs and arms flying. Good job, everyone. Nice, go Justin. Go Quentin. Last 10, then right into X planks in 5, 4, 3, 2. Come into your plank position. Tap it back, shift, back, shift, fast, fast. Final set of our heart rate boost. Kicking things over. Nice. Keep going, gang. Half done. All right, last 10. Get those hips up and back even more. We're gonna press back into downward facing dog and hold in 5, 4, 3, 2. Press your hips back. Pedal out the legs, bending alternate knees. And then walk your feet up to meet your hands. Roll up to stand. Shake it out. All right, wide leg, wide squat, jump, pulse. We go pulse, pulse, jump, pulse, pulse, jump, pulse, pulse, jump. Modification, pulse, pulse, stand. Pulse, pulse, stand. As you come up, I wanna see your arms back behind you. I don't know, wings, rocket ship, flames, whatever you wanna imagine. Down, down, boom. Explosive, whichever variation you're doing. 2 30-second sets, step those feet slightly wider than hips distance, angle the toes out. First set, let's go. Pulse, pulse, up. Pulse, pulse, up. On those pulses, let me see you get a little bit lower each time. Pulse, pulse, fly. Woo, listen to this. Good. Lucas, let me see those arms. Yeah, there we go. Awesome. Go iPhone Diana, last 5, 4, 3, 2. Everyone come up to stand. Big old generous bend in your knees. Bend your knees enough that you can grab onto your toes and then straighten your legs as much as you can, rock side to side. You can fully straighten your legs, go for it. If not, that's why we do it. Good. And roll up to stand. Second set, if you want to add an extra challenge, hands behind the head. Pulse, pulse, jump. But no rounding off the elbows. If you choose this option, your elbows have to be wide, your spine straight. If you choose to, take your hands behind your head. Second 30 seconds, go. Pulse, pulse, jump. Awesome job, Instagram. Woo! I like it. Cool, everybody's working. We have 10 more seconds. See if you can go fast. Fly, get as high as you can for 5, 4, 3, 2. Everyone step your feet wide. Hands to hips, side to side. Release it. All right. Now, it's been a few days since we've had a mountain climber competition. So every now and then we gotta throw one of those in there just to keep things exciting. So we have 30 seconds of mountain climbers, 20 seconds of mountain climbers, and then 10 seconds of mountain climbers. I want you to count those mountain climbers. So one counts as 1, 2, 3, 4. Now for these mountain climbers, I want you to see if you can get knee to opposite elbow. One. two. So we're going underneath the body. Remember, first 30 seconds, we have a whole good amount of time to be working. So sustain, moderate your pace. Everyone grab a sip of water before we go. We're gonna work out together. We're gonna hydrate together.
I'm counting on the Boston boys. The old man is dying.
I don't know if we're gonna split into West Coast, East Coast today, but whoever gives out a number, I wanna hear the number you did and where you're from, just so we can get an idea of who's in the room. So, now that we're hydrated, everyone come into plank. If you want an alternative, keep your knees on the floor, reach. Tap, tap, tap. First 30 seconds, moderate pace. If you wanna go all out, don't let me stop you, go. All right, now I'm seeing a little bit of shoulder shifting. I want to see the upper body still and stable. How well can we control the muscles of our core and upper body as we go through this? We are half done. And maybe we'll have different winners on each set. We got our long distance climbers, our shorter distance climbers. Last 10, count those numbers. We're gonna drop the knees in 5, 4, 3, 2. All right, Team Zoom, how many we got? Instagram, feel free to give us a shout if you want to report your numbers as well. We're all here together. What do we got, Zoom?
81.
81? Where are you from?
Boston.
All right, I couldn't tell who that was. 81 from Boston. What else we have?
Boston wins.
we got Come on, California. Where are we at?
80.
80. All right, there we go.
For the over 40, 54.
I love it. And where's the over 40 from? Was that John or who was that?
That's Chris.
Wait, what did you say? 54? I think I did 55.
We're not breaking up into two different teams here based on age. We're just reporting numbers. Good job, over 40 crew. All right, 20 seconds. If you didn't get the most on the long distance, see if you can go mid-range time. 20 seconds, mountain climbers, go. So far, Boston's winning, but we got a close second with 80 in California, and I see Steve's background changing, and it's awesome. All right, guys. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, rest. What do we got?
46.
How many?
46.
Woo! What else we got?
43.
43.
55 or 45? 55. Oh, my goodness. Okay. Okay. Anyone else? I want to hear a girl or any women out there. Kayleen, Sophia, Sydney, give me something. What do we get?
46.
What do we have?
46.
There we go. Thank you. All right. I knew we could hold it down. Final set. 10 seconds. All out. Make your way into position. Ready, set, go. We're fine. We have 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, stop. Knees down. Give me your numbers.
46.
46 again?
33.
29. 40. 31. I thought we would see a decline based on
18. 18.
18? You guys are killing it today. That's great. Everyone give yourself a round. Preliminary round of applause. Good job, everyone. Awesome. Now let's do core. We're going to do two sets of our core work today. Normally we just do one. We've got very important to focus on our core. I see Camille giving us a shout. 40 for each, lead 20 for both together. Nice work, nice. So we're gonna do two rounds of core. The core is actually the center, the powerhouse of all movement for our body. So if we can have a really strong core, all movement gets a lot easier. So on that note, two rounds of core, 30 seconds each, three moves. So the first one, we have a lot of alternate arm to leg stuff today. I come down into my back. I reach fingers to opposite toes. Up, down, and I want you to try and get your entire spine off the floor as you do this. So really think upper back, not just this. Try and get all the way up. So we have 30 sets of those. Then we have knee in crunches. We go out, in, out, in. If you want to do it with no hands, go for it. Last one, we have overhead rush and twist. We reach up, twist. Keep those toes off the floor, rolling as far back as you can, okay? So first move, everyone come down, alternate finger to toe taps, 30 seconds, go. Come up, tap, roll back down, up, tap. If you can't get your toes, get your knees, get something, get off your back, move through it. And as you do this, think about working the different parts of your core. So are we flinging our body weight around, or are we engaging our lower abs, mid abs, and upper abs to get as high as we can, working every part of our abs. Last 10 seconds, then we're going into knee and crunches. We have 5, 4, 3, 2. Everyone come up to sit. Feet off the floor, hands back for support. We go out, in, option to take the arms forwards. If you're feeling extra spicy today, option to reach the arms up, out, in, work that core. Your thighs might be feeling it too, that's okay. Keep drawing your belly button in towards your spine. So we're using our core and not just our hip flexors. Sometimes those start to burn. Last 10, then we're going into the overhead rush and twist in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Root your heels into the floor. Clasp those hands, over to one side, up, other side, up, working the obliques. 30 seconds here, then we have one more round of that, and we are done for the day. If you want an extra challenge, do these with your feet off the floor, up, over, up. Yeah. Awesome, guys. We're gonna make our way down onto our backs in 10. Twist as far as you can. Maybe look over the back shoulder, getting everything involved. 5, 4, 3, and 2. Everyone on your back. Arms and legs stretched all the way out. Think starfish. Alternating toe taps and go. Up, down, up, down. Get out those shoulders. Final set of these. Legs are long. We're stretching our hamstrings as we're doing it. Mm-hmm. More than half done. Now, you get to pick your own pace. So I'd rather see you keep going through the next two exercises than burn out and stop, so keep that in mind. In 5, we're gonna come up to sit for knee and crunches. We have 3, 2, 1. Everybody on your butt. Option of hands down, feet up, out, in. Option to have the arms out. Option to have the arms up. In, out, in. Imagine you're zipping your belly button all the way up towards your chin as you do this. So really engage that guy. And out, in. Last 10, keep going. We have 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Keep those heels rooted into the floor, arms come up, rush and twist. Over, up. Over, up. Last thing of the day, you can lift your feet if you want. If your feet are up, legs don't move. Side to side. There we go. Awesome. Ooh, I see some fast arms. Good, Justin. Nice, yes. In 10, we're gonna drop our legs and take a good old-fashioned hamstring stretch. We have 5, 4, 3, 2. Drop your legs. Forward fold, let everything hang. Slowing the breath down. Taking a baby bend and alternate knees. And then go ahead and take the legs wide. We're gonna walk both hands over to the right leg, frame the leg, and then walk your fingers towards your heels. I don't care how far down you can go. Let your shoulders relax and let your forehead drop down towards your right thigh. And we really don't want to force the stretch. Let the upper body hang, helping the lower body to get into the fold. And then come back up to sit. Let's rotate over to the left, frame that leg, even if you're just letting your spine round out, slouch here. This is the only time I'll allow you to do this. If you have a little bit more, you can walk fingertips towards heels. Relax the neck, relax your jaw, relax your tongue. Then roll on up to sit, give the knees a wiggle. And last thing, we're gonna come onto hands and knees. Step your left foot up and make your way up into a lunge. I promise this is for good and not evil. Take your hands to your front thigh and start to sink your hips down towards the floor, opening up the front of the right hip flexor, the quad. Keep dropping your butt lower, lifting your chest up. Now, find your right hand, take it down to the floor, and reach your left arm up for a twist. Maybe look up over that top arm. And then take the top hand down to the floor, drop the back knee, come into the tabletop, hands and knees, and we'll move into the other side. Step the right foot up, come into a lunge, other side. Bring your hands to your right thigh and drop your hips down. We want to keep squeezing our tush so that this is a front of the hip stretch as opposed to a back bend. Good, if you can, drop even lower into it. And then find your left hand, take it to the floor, reach your right arm up for a twist. And for some, this might not be a very comfortable place to be at all. See if you can breathe your way through it. Two more. And then everyone start to walk both hands over to the left, parallel the feet, nice wide-legged stretch. Roll up to stand one vertebrae at a time and bring your hands together for our final round of applause. Awesome job, everybody. Good work. Steve, I'll let you take it from here.
So, quick question. You were asking about the why we're doing this in the beginning. So, depending on whether you're looking for strength, speed, like, does the workout need to differ or just the intensity used during it?
I ask that more of just like a motivator for every person to come into their personal why, to kind of give you a reason about why you're here and kind of to keep you going through it. There are some ways that you can modify the actual exercises for building more bulk muscle versus lean muscle. But in terms of this workout, it's just your why kind of pushes you to work a little bit harder just for your own good. And Steve and John, feel free if you want to touch on any of the science behind that at all, you can.
I missed the question. Was it a strength, power, speed question or more of a general aerobic fitness question?
So it's basically like, if you're a knuckle dragger, do you do your workouts differently than you would for like what we're doing, or is it just depending on how much intensity you put into it?
So I'll answer that. For a lot of people that are in their, beyond their quote prime and beyond their elite athlete days in their 30s, 40s, 50s, or in Dr. Sato's case in his 70s, some people that are in their 80s, you can get a lot of strength and power gains with KAATSU without increasing weight. The easiest way to think of it, I think, is in Dr. Sato's case, when he does bench press with a barbell, he never puts weight on the barbell. So what is that, like 45 pounds, right? When he can get to a certain amount of reps, in his case, it's a lot of reps. He'll go as high as like 60. But when he can get a lot of reps, he doesn't add any weight, he adds pressure. And when he adds pressure, he gets this very similar physiological outcomes as when you're doing weight training when you, you know, that whole 80%, one rep max, you tear down muscle fibers, but then you get that recovery and that inflammation response. When you're doing it the way Dr. Sato does it, you're not getting that inflammation response. You're not tearing down muscle fibers, so you can gain in strength and power, and it helps with agility and a lot of other things as well. Does that kind of answer it? Low weight.
Yeah, yeah, that answers it. I was more just wondering, like, the workouts we've been doing are just awesome and just great mobility wise and everything. I was just wondering if you're a swimmer or if you're, you know, a team guy or anything like that, if you change anything or if it's just good all around.
So I personally think it's good all around. Go ahead, Laura.
Yeah, I can speak to that one. So I actually was ex-water polo player, now yogi. And so I try and cater the workouts because we have such a diverse group of us that we always have some flexibility, some mobility, some cardio, and strength to try and hit all those groups. And with that being said, if there's anyone on here who doesn't feel like the workout is targeting or kind of speaking to your group, feel free to let me know. But it should kind of be a one size fits all as best you can.
Hit a little bit of everything. Yeah. Yeah.
Everything. Yeah.
I have a cool insight on this. So I swim with the KAATSU bands and so does Quentin. And we've always done that. And this is our first like kind of workout with the KAATSU bands. So in terms of like where you were saying it, how it like tackles virtually everything and like how you're using it with water polo, it kind of, you just use it in different mobilities. And like Chris is our coach and we will do like hard sets, like just getting full, what is this, intensity going. And then you get build up that lactic acid and then you'll like calm down and then hit it again, if that helps.
Thank you, that's awesome.
That's my boy. And I think Steve was on, just for everyone and also who's new, even for my own self, I think one thing to be really aware of and cognizant is your heart rate is going to spike when you have the bands on at an appropriate pressure. Like I was dying.
Yeah.
So Steve, I don't know if this is the vent, you know, maybe one time we can just have a 1 minute why our heart rate goes up so quickly.
I think you're muted, Steve.
We can't hear you,
Steve. I think he's talking.
Yeah.
I see his lips moving.
Maybe you can hit on it, John.
Well, yeah, I mean, when you have the bands and they're in the inflated state, your whole body is going to react to that as if there's metabolic, I mean, we are creating metabolic stress, but it's extra, right? So even if we're not moving at all, let's say we're just laying down totally passive and the bands are going through this inflation sequence, we're still expanding and relaxing vascular tissue, right? The heart and the body are going to respond to that with an increased heart rate. In some cases, a increased cardiac output. Some people, that I think of it is, it's a way to get exercise in a passive form. Now, when you start integrating Laurel's functional movement and strength movements, your heart just treats that as super, super intense. Your brain treats had a super intense exercise. So yeah, it's a great way to get after it in a short amount of time, effective and efficient. Hey, one quick thing for the group here, little tip for today. If you're running this device in cycle mode and you have the bands hooked up and for whatever reason it doesn't seem to be finishing the cycle and it's just kind of running continuously, or maybe it's not making it past the sixth or seventh cycle, you might have a pinhole leak in one of these tubes. Super easy fix. Almost always the pinhole leak is right here. And all you do is you just remove that very tip part of the plastic, because the pinhole leak will be right at the very tip there. And you can cut off that last quarter inch and then reattach it and it fixes it. So 95% of the time, if there's a leak, it happens in one of four places, either here on each side or here at those connection points.
Could I ask a question?
And the best.
Could I ask a question on that? That's what I thought I might have, but that's the issue I've been having. But at times, it would go up to the level it needs to go up. So if I had a pinhole, it shouldn't go up at all, ever. So
if you have a pinhole leak, it will.
80% of the time during this video, I wasn't able to get it to the number I wanted. It would just run, like you said. But then a few times it would go to the 200s I wanted. So with the pinhole, would it go at all, ever? Could that be the issue?
It'll still, if it's a pinhole leak, it'll still go up to a certain level. But then once there's enough pressure, it won't get above that. And you'll find the compressor running excessively.
It could get to like 200s on occasion, and then it would just stay at 25 most of the other time. It's such a big difference. With the pinhole, is that possible, or is it something in the machine? I mean, I'll
troubleshoot it with you. You know, just point to point offline, and we can go through it. I just, as a general statement, that's usually where it is, and you can just cut off the tip of it and fix it.
I mentioned it now in case if anybody else had the same issue.
Yeah. Is it Camille?
Yes, it is. Yes, Camille.
If you just stay on at the end of the call here, I'll run through a couple things with you.